My name is Teemu Pohjanlehto, also known as Rep from TRSI and Paradise. This is a talk about pure data. Anyone knows what pure data is? Or have you used this? Okay, one, two.
Is that the node-considered thing?
Yeah, it's basically a visual programming language for audio. So I work at Songhai. It's an iOS mobile company. And we are building our audio engine with pure data, so it will be dynamic, and we can squeeze more music to the small space. This is what our game look like. Might look familiar from some King game. So what pure data is, it's open source visual programming language. It can be used for also for 2D or 3D graphics, interface sensors, input devices, MIDI. So basically, you can do about anything with it. It's very similar to Max MSP. Anyone knows that? Okay, good. So it looks like this. So you are basically connecting nodes to make a functionality you want to do. So basic building blocks in pure data is objects. Object can be anything like oscillator, amp. Then you can use externals. So when there isn't a functionality you want to do, you can program it yourself. It's really simple, even I can do that. Then there's abstractions, which is a complete batch saved and load back as an object. So that's the way to hide complexity in the batches so they don't look like rat's nests. Then there's something called subbatch, which is almost same than abstraction. That's the difference, that is, it is saved with the current patch. So if you change and multiply it, you can change the values individually. If you have abstractions, it's always the same. So if you change one value into abstractions, everything changes with it. So why to use pure data? It's much faster if you are making an audio engine from scratch. We have something like three guys working on it, and it's been 3 months. And it's in a state that we can test it and release something on it. You can also take audio designers to work with you, because usually DSP programming is like a black magic. But if you are familiar with synths and stuff like that, you can do stuff with pure data without programming. There's many examples and books on pure data and Max MSP, because they are almost the same. You can use same stuff than Max MSP in pure data. And usually it is used for procedural music, so you can squeeze a lot of musical content in tiny footprint. We have something like 2 hours of music in 6 megs on iOS. And why not use pure data? If you are using it like a normal demo code away, let's do something, the patches can come like rat's nest, and it's very, very hard to debug what is going on. And sometimes it's very tricky to do basic things that you can do with programming language. Like you think that, yeah, this is simple, it probably isn't in pure data that simple. So how it differs from Max MSP? It has the same maker. Miller Puket did also the MSP part of the Max MSP, but the Max MSP is a commercial product. So of course it comes with better documentation, better support. And what's worse on Max MSP with pure data, there's libpd, which is basically pure data without any GUI. So you can use it on iOS, Android, Windows, or Mac. And they actually used pure data in Spore to make the procedural music in it. So it works also on big scale commercial products. So how do you integrate it for your demos or games? There's several possibilities, like for Unity, which we use. There's something called Kalimba. For your own game engines or demos, you can use libpd, which is basically just pure data without a GUI. Or you can make your own. So what Kalimba is, it's libpd binding for Unity 3D. It only uses vanilla objects, which is something that usually restricts you, because there's two versions of pure data. There's normal pure data, and then there's pure data extended, where people have added their own externals. So if you want to use anything that isn't in the vanilla PD, you have to compile yourself. And if you are working for iOS game like we do, there's a lot of restrictions in licenses in Apple Store. So you have to be really, really careful what you are using, or they don't accept it. So what Kalimba basically does, on a Unity, you can send bangs of loads. Bang is like a starting point that you can say sign on, and on pure data, you can catch that sign on and play a sign out. So it basically is a trigger. And then you can send numbers if you want to change something, like player makes three moves, you can send three to pure data and react for that. LibBD is something different. You can basically do whatever you want. You don't have any limitations. So it's been used in RAM machines, loop layers, like RGDG on iOS. And it has much more control over Kalimba. So if you really need to go deep in your game engine, you must use LibBD. And one option is, of course, do your own. You can basically live control over MIDI or make your own format, if that is what you want to do. The file format of pure data is plain text, so it's easy to parse. You can design synths for your own audio engine without using pure data's audio engine, because it's like this. Here it says that it has an oscillator, an output, and 330 hertz, and there's text output on it. It first says the objects and then how they connect to each other. So it's really simple to pass this to your own engine, like this. Here I'm basically doing my own sign calculations, and if I just, I have a little parser that makes from pure data file, so I can make Amiga 500 synths on pure data. So this is a cool thing that it's open, and you can easily do whatever you want. So how Raspberry Pi comes in, it has both pure data and libpd too. It can be used as hardware synths or prototyping your own effects without buying DSP cards or setups. You can make like guitar pedals, synths, vocoders. It's really, really simple to use. You can basically get a connection over Secure Shell. So you don't actually need a display for it. Okay. Let's try this. So you could basically set up this like your own computer and use it to make the patches. Or if you are short in space or want to just use one computer, you can make this Secure Shell. And it, at least in OS X, it supports also Windows. So you can get graphics. Let's see if this works now. So it's not super fast, but it's okay. So you can have like MIDI inputs straight to the Raspberry Pi, and it should detect them automatically. The own audio output from Raspberry Pi, it's not that good, but you can live with it. And you can basically do like a old super sources. Okay, we have a little distortion. So this is basically an abstract representation of one oscillator. It has seven saw oscillators which are detuned. So you make one oscillator like this. It's actually from here, you can check it out. And then when you use abstract JSONs, you can just make like, I want three. There's a root. And this basically makes you have a mini node in. Then you have polyphony of three. Then you pack the information and route them to different oscillators. So this is not that hard. Then you have a sliders for volume and detune. So you can basically, if you have a good MIDI controller, you can like basically make your own synths really easily. So at least on Raspberry Pi and iOS, and I guess also on Android, there's a problem that when you do your patches with like MacBook or something like that, you have a lot of CPU time. But when you are going for low hardware, you should always check the performance on real target. And if you are using iOS or Xcode, you can actually see what patches take CPU, how much. So it's really easy to optimize them. Like there's a TabRead, which is used as an oscillator. It has cubic interpolation in TabRead 4, and we actually made just TabRead 2 to save CPU time. You can also make tables dynamically if you are doing like Rumbler. So basically in Pure Data you can use message box to make tables on fly. It only works on sub-patches for some reason. It should work also for the main patch, but it doesn't. So basically what it allows, you can create what you need at the point where you need it. So you can basically have like a lot of samples in the SD card and load them just when you need it. It's the same in the iOS, because you have restricted memory. You can get more samples in it and load when you need it. You basically make like a text file and read samples to tables, and when you don't need it anymore, you just flush them and save some memory. You can also utilize bus scripts. So if you like to do some conversions of text files, which is sometimes a little bit hard on the Pure Data, you can use this shell object. You just give it the object name. It takes command line parameters. You can wrap it to the parameters, so you can actually make the file name on the fly if you like. It gets the shell output to outlet one, and it bangs on outlet two when the script is done, so you know it's done. So it looks like this. This open panel opens a file selector. It adds .shazm to the file for some reason, and then it runs the script with the file name as command line parameter, and then the processor data comes from outlet one and bang from outlet two when it's done. So it's really simple to do if you don't like to hard code your own, like you want to process MIDI files, you don't want to write that in C, you can do it in a script if you like or anything. It's easier to make text file data parsers. It's good for one-time conversions that you are not doing all the time. So you can go with format X to more PD friendly. So we have this case, we wanted to play MIDI files without externals. There's this something called CycloneSec. This is basically a MIDI parser. And then there's something called GooList, which is basically a text file which has one parameter for time and one for node you are playing for. So it's like simplified MIDI file. But you cannot actually load MIDI files to it. So what you need to do, the Cyclone outputs a text file which has absolute time, and then it has a MIDI node, what it should be playing. So what I basically did, I just did in C a little program that converts absolute time to delta time. It adds keyboards note on and note off, and made a shell script that starts that. So basically I load a MIDI file in PD, and then I have a output, what I can use for GooList, so I don't have to write my own mini parser or use externals for it. I really want to thank my colleagues, Esa Ruoho, also known as Lackluster, and Matti Pesonen for this. Do you have any questions?